Welcome to Kratos BI. My name is Chris Wagner, and today we're going to be doing a deep dive into building your own custom visual with no code. In fact, we're even going to do something that people have asked for a very long time, which is creating a small multiple visual with no coding whatsoever. Let's get to it. Boom. All right, over on KratosBI.com, we have the home of the data gods. This week, we've been featuring all of the work of Mike Carlo. Mike is one of the pros that created Power BI Tips, along with Seth, and he's got an incredible tool out there called the Chart Builder. If you go out to Power BI Tips, click on No Code Custom Visuals, and it's gonna bring you out this charts.powerbi.tips. And you can start to build out your visual. Now, Mike has a video out there walking you through how to create this stuff. It's really pretty easy to get to. If you're out on his profile site on KratosBI.com, click on the YouTube icon and it'll take you out to their channel. One of the most popular videos that they have is actually how do you create this visual. Now, it's right here, creating a Power BI. We're not going to jump too far into it, but building a custom visual, your basic bar chart. Highly recommend. If you're going to start doing this stuff, go out, watch this video. I'll put the link in the description down below so you can check it out. It's really pretty great. He does an excellent job of walking you through the basics of it. Today I went through this like 6 or 7 times. I watched through this whole thing, worked through the whole video, making sure I understood how all of this would work for you. And in doing so, I found out it's really easy to do some pretty cool things inside of the Power BI custom visual generator. But we're gonna start with a little pro tip, and Mike actually covered it inside the Pug meeting last week. And that's, if you start building out this custom visual, start in Power BI. Start with a grid of data that has what it is what you're going to be building a visual for. In this case, I'm looking at fiscal year, I'm looking at English product category, and I'm looking at internet sales amount using the Kratos BI data file that's available out on the site. All right, I'm going to save this guy as, and we're going to call this Power BI Tips Custom Visual. So I've got my data file here. I've extracted it. I can go ahead. I can take a look at this data file. I can make sure that it's got all the data that I want in it. Now, a tip for you, this is another tip, is that make sure that you don't have any dollar symbols in here. The Power BI Tips thing, it's gonna think that's a string and you're gonna have some little wonky behavior with it. So make sure that you don't have that. And you're gonna go into the charting tool. First thing it's gonna ask you to do is open or drag or drop a file. Click on this, select your sample file and import it. It's gonna take a look at the information that's coming in. As long as this is right, you can go ahead and click on done. Mike has a great video out there that'll walk you through the basics of it. I'm going to show you how to do something insanely cool in a real short period of time. So I'm going to create multiple regions, and I'm going to use that the same data to visualize that inside of a singular visual. So this is actually super cool. So I'm going to go ahead. First things first. I'm going to create my visual pane here. So I've got one pane here, or what they call this here, a 2D region, one big 2D region, a small one here. Now I'm gonna move this in, and I'm gonna move this down. Oh, that didn't do it. So I'm gonna start all over. I'm gonna create one here. I'm gonna create another one right here. And then I'm gonna create a second one right there. So I now have three regions, right? Three regions in which I've got my grid available for me to start building out my content. Now, first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna make this guy a circle chart. This guy is gonna be my line, and then this guy is gonna be my classical bar chart. Inside my glyphs, this is where we add in the types of visuals that we're going to see. I'm going to use bar because it's going to be the easiest to visualize what it is we're looking for, right? As you can kind of see, once I've added this in, it's already starting to take shape as to what it is I'm looking for. So my internet sales amount, I want that to be my height. And then I'm going to go through and I'm going to define how I want these things broken out internally here. So fiscal year, we're going to break that out all around the edge. And we're going to do the same thing onto the x-axis here. Right? And we're going to add in bikes there. And you know what, this guy, we're gonna set that to the middles, and then we're gonna drag my internet sales there and internet sales here. Right? Oh, that doesn't look good. What did I do wrong here? There we go. So now I can go ahead. This is looking fairly good. I'm going to go down here and I'm going to change some of the stuff inside of here to give myself a little more color to this. Like, for example, I'm going to change this color. Now, you don't necessarily have to change the color in here. I just kind of like the way it looks. Change it on shape. And they've got a really nice color picker in here. This is beautiful. So I'm gonna go with this color. I'm gonna go up here. I'm gonna delete. Oh, I don't want to delete that. I don't want to have a title. So I don't want this title here. So I'm gonna go over to my chart selection here, and I'm gonna remove it all together. Right. I'm gonna upgrade this bar chart to give myself a little more room in here, and I've now created my visual. So it's one visual based off of this data set, but I've got a radial chart in there. I've got a combination like bar chart, and then I've got another one down here. So super easy to do. Now I want to bring this into Power BI. I want to test this out. When I go to export it, I click on the export button, click on Power BI Custom Visual. Now, best practice here is if you're gonna be building these visuals, you'd wanna use it so that you can reuse it, you can repeat it a whole bunch of times and whatnot. In this case, I'm not gonna do it, so that just makes it a little easier for me to follow along with what's going on. Michael would say, oh, you gotta rename it, and he is right. If I was going to do this and keep this visual for beyond anything, I definitely would. But this would be my small multiples. My name is Chris Wagner. Data God at KratosBI.com. All right. I click on that button. It's gonna generate the PBI viz file for me. So this is going to be my downloads file. Now all I have to do is come back over to Power BI, click on import from file. It's going to caution me, you know, be careful, you could create viruses, breaches of security, all that good stuff. And it's true, you need to be careful with this stuff, but in this case, I know this is going to be fine. So I'm going to click on import. I'm going to go down to my downloads. There's my small multiples. I'm going to click on open. That was going to be added into my visual. So now I'm going to do the biggest cheat thing I know how. Copy, paste, and then I'm going to replace that visual. Now, if you're like me, you're going to get this exact same message, or you're going to always get this message. It's going to say like, hey, you're missing something here. And fortunately, it's because we left these things the same, the names right, it's easy for us to see where we need to make our changes. So I need to make sure that I have my internet sales amount is in internet sales. I need to make sure that I have my English product category in English product category, and then I have fiscal year brought into fiscal year. Come on now. All right, and boom. Now I've added in and I've created my small multiples Power BI custom visuals. And it's all interactive. It works just the way my Power BI, you know, any visual you'd expect inside of Power BI to work, it's all right there. Think you'll agree, this is about as easy as it could possibly get to create your own Power BI custom visual. Mike, wow, you are a godsend. Realistically, this is something that everyone really owes Mike a huge, you know, thank you for putting out there and doing. It makes creating any Power BI visual that you want super easy, piece of cake, barely an inconvenience. So Mike, hey, thank you very much for putting this together. As always, thank you guys very much for watching. Like and subscribe to the video if you want to see more of this stuff. And if you really like this content, go ahead, go out to KratosBI.com, buy me a coffee, and I'll send you, while supplies last, I'll send you one of these really awesome, magic-looking I Love Power BI stickers. All right, thank you all very much. You guys have a great day, and we'll see you next time.